Hey guys, welcome back to today's video. So today we have the Abominable Snowman versus Frosty the Snowman. This is a very hotly contested election, considering that Frosty the Snowman has been talking about running for years now, since the 1900s, and the Abominable Snowman is finally coming back for revenge after their encounter on Snow Hill. So we're going to figure this out. And Frosty the Snowman, of course, is running under the Democratic Party, because he said he would never join the Republican Party under Donald Trump. So the Abominable Snowman, of course, took the Republican nomination, and we're now just going to see how it plays out. So we're going to go up to a state like Oregon and California. They really like Frosty the Snowman, although they don't get a lot of snow. They're both snowmen, so there's no really snow racism here or snowcism. And people treat them equally because they don't have any other options and there are no major third parties. But a state like Washington would go to the Abominable Snowman because they are more, they look more mountainy. So the Abominable Snowman, essentially a Yeti, lives up there. And they pretty much live in like weird states like Wyoming, other weird states like Utah, South Dakota. You know, there's always Yeti sightings in these states. And then sometimes they go all the way up to Alaska, so he would win Alaska, especially with the Republican appeal. Considering the Abominable Snowman has been very outspoken during this election season, you would expect him to win in states that are traditionally conservative. He's pro-life. He said he would, quote-unquote, rather eat the babies than abort them, so he has doing well with that part of the conservative vote. So he would have won in a state like West Virginia, Oklahoma, solid conservative states. But Frosty the Snowman also said that he would want to invest in Native American snowman building, so he would win in areas like North Dakota and Montana and Idaho. But then we go up to the Northeast, the Abominable Snowman doing very well here with his ground game. From the state of New York, where his first sighting was located, going over the Appalachian Mountains, but the Abominable Snowman would win in a state like New York. Vermont also would connect, and then we go across nearing the Appalachian Mountains, going to a state like Virginia. The Abominable Snowman has doing very well in polling here. You would expect him to win, but going down to a state like North Carolina, considering that they had a random gust of snow, that was accredited to Frosty the Snowman, so he would win there. I made a correction in one of my last videos in the state of Florida, a state that I gave to Donald Trump against Frosty the Snowman because there wasn't a lot of snow. Actually, there was 8 inches of snow, and again, Frosty the Snowman looks like the eventual victor there. Going over to a state like Texas, that's a very important state. So Frosty the Snowman, as you know, has a cigar. So the state of Texas looks like a head, like right here, and this is their cigar. So he would win the state of Texas. But then going over to a state like Hawaii, remember the Abominable Snowman can live in warmer climates. So Hawaii, Arizona, Georgia, South Carolina would go to the Abominable Snowman. Going up to a state like Maryland, the Abominable Snowman is very popular here, coming from the Northeast, definitely more of an appeal, especially with the white working class, considering that they're both white. Neither of them really turn on minorities, but Frosty the Snowman definitely is more integrated with the people. I mean, he made a lot of friends who were kids and were really sad when he melted, but that would help him win in states like Colorado, where it's very cold. But going over to a state like Nevada, you can expect the Abominable Snowman and a state like New Mexico for him to win there. Then we're going to go across the Red Wall to Nebraska and Kansas. Here, I think Frosty the Snowman would make gains here because of the fact that Frosty is a strong candidate. The Central Plains doesn't really get that much snow, but it is flat. Frosty the Snowman, when he melts to liquid, he turns flat. The Abominable Snowman doesn't really melt. Again, with the appeal to the warmer voters, he would win in the Deep South, the Old South, as some would say. But then going up to the North, the Super North, states like Maine, Michigan, Wisconsin, and Minnesota, Frosty the Snowman would make considerable gains there. The Abominable Snowman did really well against Donald Trump in the New Hampshire primary. You have to give him props there. John Kasich endorsed him in Ohio as well, so that would put him there. Then going to a state like Illinois, the Abominable Snowman is very popular. I mean, if you look at the way that the shape is turned out, it kind of looks like a Yeti. I mean, if you have like a different imagination and you're crazy, you know, it would look like the Abominable Snowman. Considering the fact that he is a Yeti, he would pretty much, Iowa looks like Abraham Lincoln's head, so he would lose that state, because what state would want to lose their head to a snowman? And then the state of Indiana, Vice President Mike Pence's home state, very important state for the Frosty the Snowman column, that would go to him. But then again, with the Northeastern appeal, he would win in a state like Massachusetts, Rhode Island, Connecticut. Delaware, I'm a little more iffy about, but since that Frosty the Snowman is a little more active on the campaign trail, talking to voters, he would win in states like Missouri, and he can appeal to a lot of the people in the state of, in the states like New Jersey, where he would win, and I think he would win the general election in the state of New Jersey, but I also think that in D.C. and Delaware, I think the Abominable Snowman would do a little bit better, considering that the Abominable Snowman's paws, are not white. That gives him somewhat of a minority factor. Remember, many people in his campaign have been using that. So essentially, he could win in more predominantly minority areas. So this is the final electoral map. 275 electoral votes for Frosty the Snowman and the Abominable Snowman with 263. Thank you guys for watching this video, and I'll see you all tomorrow.